When you add be you plus live your purpose, what do you get? Joy. That's the motto of Unstuck Joy with Vicki Todd. Vicki believes you were born with gifts that you're meant to use to make the world a brighter place. Have you ever wondered, is this all life has to offer? There must be more. If you answer yes, then Unstuck Joy is the show for you. Each show will feature a memoir artwork painted by Vicki that taps into universal themes of evolution, hope, inner strength, and self-growth. Vicki will also ask listeners to play along. Draw, doodle, collage, write, and or paint your way to soul clarity with art vision journaling. Unstuck Joy will compel you to tune into your soul's whispers to realize your unique dreams. Get ready to get unstuck.
Hey, everybody. It is so great to be connecting with all of you. This is kind of cool. We're doing something really for the first time. You know, I'm Dr. Pat. I am so excited. My co-host joining me here today is Vicki Todd. Today, we're going to be talking about your spirit guides are talking. Are you listening? Vicki, this is like a first.
This is a lot of firsts. I have never painted in front of people before. Because that's been one of my things. I've been very vulnerable and just want to do that behind closed doors and then take pictures if I feel okay with what I'm producing. Right. And so to do it in front of people live on Facebook, this is a huge day.
I know. It's kind of huge for me, too, because, you know, there are some reasons that people say that there are those of us that literally do radio. And now the world has changed so much. You know, here at Transformation Talk Radio, we do this thing called visual radio. And doing this today, I got to kudos to Benny, to Alex behind the scenes, and Jessica. So yeah. For those of you that are watching on Facebook, and if you're not watching on Facebook and you're listening, I should probably tell you how to watch on Facebook. Go to the Dr. Pat Show on Facebook, and hopefully there will be. And if not, Jessica will tell me what I need to say to everybody. Today's show, I love this. Spirit guides, right? We're talking about this. I don't know about you, but I haven't always been awake enough to know that the universe is communicating with me. Can you tell us a little bit about this? Is it always communicating with us?
It is always communicating with us. And I'm in the same boat, Pat, because yeah. This is kind of a new world for me. And so, you know, it's just when you start noticing things, like in my life, it will be maybe my grandmother who passed in 1995, and I'll explain some of this later, but, you know, she'll show up in a meditation or in a dream every once in a while. Or like in nature, I'll notice certain bugs or birds or, you know, I got a feather last night on my kitchen floor, which was a new one for me. And so, you know, you can very easily just say, that's nothing. I'm going to throw that nasty thing in the trash. Or you can say, oh, what does that mean? And then Google it, you know, so I Googled and then I looked at the color of the feather and, you know, so, and then you have to interpret it. So the universe is always communicating with you, is kind of sitting back waiting for you to accept the messages and decide to do something with it. And I think that's really cool because it makes me feel like we're not alone. You know, these things are to help us along our path.
Yeah. And, you know, one of the things we're talking about is how these communications happen, but also more importantly, what exactly are spirit guides? Now, you and I have something in common that we didn't know we had in common, and that is we express ourselves, believe it or not, through art.
Yes.
I've actually been called, what is the term? I think you actually called me this, a radio artist.
Yes.
And I thought, no, that's like not right. That can't be right. But there are all sorts of forms. And what I said to you is, every time I do a show, something changes in me. If you meet me for coffee, you'll have to pull the words out of me. But here, somebody's talking to me. How is that working for you?
That's really good. I like that. The whole thing with painting in front of people, it was only a year and a half ago. I was working with a life coach, and this was, you know, a few months after I had resigned from my 12-year tenured professor position. And I could not claim or identify myself as an artist, because I had all of these really deep-seated, sticky, limiting beliefs that art is frivolous. You know, that's not a value to anything. It's something that you do after retirement. Oh, nobody's going to like your art. And so, you know, kind of hide it. And so I was working with a life coach a year and a half ago to really claim my identity as an artist and be able to say, when people say, what do? That's the first thing now that comes out of my mouth. And that started translating into writing my visual memoir, Unstuck. And I use some of my memoir portraits to tell the story along with the words. And of course, my website. And eventually, you know, moving to Washington State, I have some of my artwork up in two local establishments, which is kind of a first for me. And I have never, ever, ever been comfortable with allowing people, even people close to me, to watch me paint. And it has hit me in the past couple of months. I think, you know, the producer, Linda, of the show, she had mentioned it. I was like, hell no, I don't want to do that, because it really scared me to death. But then I kept working with it, and these intuitive downloads started coming in. And I thought, that's a way for me to step even further into my life purpose of being an artist, is to put it first. Because a lot of times, even though I discovered art is my purpose in 2013 via meditation, it still kind of comes last. You know, it's like, oh, if you have time for it. And, you know, it's kind of a tool in the workshops. But this today is really a big step for me to put it first, do it in front of people. And my hope is, with the energy of it, you know, to me, art is medicine, because it's healing, it brings joy. And so I'm hoping that somehow the energy of this, the universe will translate that out to the listeners and viewers out there, and they can feel the emotion, the feelings behind what I'm going to paint. And hopefully that will translate into them, whatever their calling is, to step even further and deeper into their own calling, whatever that means in their own life.
So I got to tell you about this. Listen, I got to tell you about this, because our listeners are watching this. And I am like, you got to be kidding me. I got to give you all a shout out, because I'm telling you, this is not just a stretch for Vicki, but this is a super stretch for me. Because yay. Benny will tell you, it is really easy for us to get into the studio and sit behind a big fat microphone, right?
Right.
But coming out in the world is a breakthrough moment.
Yes.
So congratulations with you. And for all of you that are listening and you're watching, watching on Facebook, and I apologize in advance for not even telling you, like, I don't even know how to tell you how to watch, because it's really more than that. It's about you and I, Vicki, wanting to connect with people. So today, maybe you all listening will say, what is that thing that I've always wanted to do,
right,
that I just have not been able to do? So tell us about these animal spirit guides. And by the way, can you see this on my chest right there? That's
what,
like,
is it?
It's a little puppy.
Oh, cute.
So do you think maybe puppy, maybe my little animal spirit, since this is my my mouse pet?
I love it. Yes, that's a perfect example. So I'm going to paint as we talk. And so hopefully it's like walking and chewing gum. I hope I can do it. But with
spit out my gum before the show today.
But with your spirit guides, it's whatever resonates with you and makes sense to you. And so, like I said, for me, it's certain animals, certain insects, certain people in my family who have passed. And so you may have other people in your life that say, oh, you know, I've seen the same puppy, or I have the same grandmother or whatever. But, you know, it doesn't resonate with them in a spirit kind of way, you know, to give these messages. And so it's whatever resonates with you. And they're there to help you, to guide you, to move further on your true self path. And so they're not going to give you the whole picture of what your true self path is, but it's going to be one message at a time. And I like to think of it, did you ever listen to or read Women Who Run With the Wolves?
Yeah.
If people haven't gotten into that, I would totally recommend the audio, because she has such a beautiful voice, and she's a storyteller, and she sings and really vocalizes. But I love the story of La Loba, who is an old woman who lives in the desert. And she goes out and, you know, rummages through the desert, the dried up riverbeds, and up into the mountains, and picks you know, lost wolf bones of, wow. you know, a skeleton, and they're all separate, you know, they're all spread all over the place. And so she brings them back to her cave, and she starts reassembling the wolf bones into a complete wolf skeleton on the floor of her cave. And when the skeleton is complete, she begins to sing over it. And as she sings over it, the wolf begins to take shape again and to breathe and to flesh out, and its fur comes out. And then when it's a full wolf again, it hops up, runs out of the cave, and runs into the desert, and it becomes this beautiful woman running free. And that's your wild woman spirit running free. So that's how I like to think of these messages from our spirit guides. It's one little bone at a time that we're assembling into our true self. You know, we're evolving and working up into that. And when we sing over it, meaning, you know, we pick up the feather that was on your kitchen right. floor, and instead of throwing it away, you say, oh, what does that mean? Let me look it up on Google or in a book or whatever. Then that is singing over it. And that's going to allow us to evolve into our true self, our wild woman spirit or wild man spirit, and just run toward and be free, you know, this ultimate life that we were born to live. So that's how I like to think of the messages. It's one little thing at a time, and you put them together.
Yeah. And you know what I love about what you're sharing is that some people think that actually the way it works is, oh, I've got this one spirit animal, or I get this one spirit thing, right? And I don't know about you, but I know I have a couple that I've resonated with over time. But in one sense, I'm starting to notice how different animal spirits show up, meaning like, you know, today, for whatever reason today, in my life, I have seen more rabbits than I can imagine. I'm a girl from the Bronx, okay? you know, I mean, it took me like, I think till I was 50 to actually know what a rabbit actually really looked like. But wow. The point is that now I'm seeing them all the time. The other thing I'm noticing, Vicki, in this is, you know, I have a studio here. We have a studio we go to where Benny sits. I have a studio then in my home office. And when I'm at the studio in the home office, really weird. Every time I'm sitting there doing a show, this random cat from the neighborhood comes by and sits outside this giant, like, 12-foot glass, sliding glass door.
Wow.
And it's like this cat. And I don't even know who this cat is. And I thought to myself, wow, we are talking about this today.
Yeah.
Now, yesterday, I was getting ready for this show, and my friends tell me this is kind of weird, but I don't know how weird it is. I'm getting ready for the show, and outside my window, I've got these planters, and this giant, I guess it's a blue jay, although I don't know it's a blue jay. It's a bird, and it's beautiful, but it's got this pointed kind of, you know, pointed head.
Like a cone?
Like a cone head,
yeah.
Thank you. And then all of a sudden, it's like just staring at me. And I'm thinking to myself, say something to it. Now, I would imagine that some people are looking and saying, Pat, you know, that's just a little strange. Actually not. How has it been for you, Vicki? In my life, I know that what I've had to do is I've had to stop, breathe, and sometimes it is talking to a bird. Sometimes it is talking to a cat. How about you?
Absolutely. And I love these examples that you're giving because, like, you know, the cat showing up outside your window or a certain bird, that would be so easy to overlook and just say, ah, you know, it's the neighbor's cat again, whatever. Right. But you're paying attention to it. And so your intuition is saying something to you. Pay attention to that bird. Pay attention to that cat. And that's where the singing over the bones comes in. Is to say, okay, what does that message mean to me? And that's what I mean. It may not mean the same to somebody else, but if that means something to you and you feel it in your intuition, and we'll talk about that later, how to really feel that this is a valid message, that's what it's all about. So it really is a very personal thing.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's take a short break. When we come back, we're going to talk about our animal spirits in our life. Vicki's going to talk to us about what she's actually doing here now. I would love to invite all of you to give us a shout in or on Facebook, Jessica, please help me out here. On Facebook, what are the animals that are so important to you? Post your picture, let us know, or call in 1-800-930-2819. Tell us what they are, or there's so many ways to communicate. Go to the Dr. Pat Show on the right-hand side. Just type it in there. What is the animal that talks to you? We'll be right back.
Okay, all clear.
The Transformation Network, for me, is a place where we get to provide people with that opportunity to step in to the world of possibilities. You know, the galaxy of the infinite. The Transformation Network is going to grow exponentially because of all of the people that are saying yes to joining us. I hope you'll be one of them. I hope you will come join us, so that together we'll be able to create a place where people go beyond inspiration, go beyond education, and become conscious contributors and change agents in the world.
Hey, everybody. I want to super duper welcome you to the Dr. Pat Show. This is Talk Radio to Thrive By.
Hi, everybody, and welcome back this week to Wonderful Angels and Answers with Artie Hoffman and Sky Siegel. You're with us, baby.
I'm having such a good time.
Would you pass me one of those donuts?
Hello, I'm Dr. Jen, and welcome to the show today.
Hi, this is Colette Marie Steffen, and you are listening to The Truth is Funny on Transformation Talk Radio.
Welcome to Get Sophisticated with Sophisticated Guys.
Welcome back to Voices of Women. I'm Chris Stainis.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Christine Upchurch Show, where we have stellar conversations to illuminate your journey.
And I would like to invite each of you, if you have a purpose, if you have a passion, if you don't really know how to get that out into the world, join our radio family. We are so in awe of all of what you have done, all that you continue to do. And that's why we've created an opportunity for all of you to join us.
I got to have a little rock and roll every once in a while in my life. Welcome back. Hey, everybody. I'm Dr. Pat. Vicki, Todd joining me here today. This is a really cool thing we're doing here with the show. First, let me give a shout out to all of you that are watching on Facebook. Thanks a lot. This is new for both Vicki and I. This is like our virgin experience with this. But more importantly, this is, for those of you out there, we're talking about our animal spirits and how important they are. Please go to social media, the Dr. Pat Show. Apparently, Jessica says if you go to the Dr. Pat Show on Facebook, like, it's right there, what Vicki's doing. And then if you go there, type in and tell us, you know, what is the animal that speaks with you? And then for those of you that want to call in and let us know, we'll bring you on air, right? 1-800-930-2819. Vicki, tell everybody what you're doing. This is kind of cool.
Okay. So I am doing my first ever live painting on a live show, craziness, in front of people. And so this is me stepping even further, taking it up a notch to step into my purpose as an artist and using my art to inspire others. So my hope is that the energy and emotion and feeling from this will resonate out to our listeners on Facebook and elsewhere and inspire them to step further, deeper into their own purpose and life calling, whatever that may be. So that's the hope with this. So hi, everybody.
Well, I think it is a great hope. I mean, you know, when I'm thinking about what we're doing this year and, you know, launching 10 channels, and now we've got our two crowdfunding ideas that we're getting ready to bring forth. You know, there's so many people, Vicki, that show up as naysayers, and they want to, you know, just kind of say to us, you know what, wait a minute. You know, like, dude, what makes you so blah, blah, blah. Right. Now, I don't know about you, but I'll tell you about me. I've learned over time not to listen to most of that, but every once in a while, I will pay attention to somebody that comes in and somehow says something to me, and I'm just all crazy with it. I'm just like totally berserk with it. How has your animals, how have you heard from them that this is what you're supposed to be doing?
That's an excellent question. Because that's the absolute truth. I've had people in my life to say, you're going to do what? You know, you're going to quit your stable job and just go off and be an artist? You can't make money doing that. What are you thinking? And so let me get into this by sharing some of my examples, because that's the best way to explain it. Because like I said, your spirit guides. It doesn't have to just be animals. It could be people in your life who have passed. It could be things in nature, like my little feather that showed up on my kitchen floor yesterday. Rainbows have started popping up for me lately, you know, whether it's a picture on Facebook or in the sky. You may have non-physical spirit guides that you invite in, and I'm kind of baby stepping my way toward that. I think I've identified three, I haven't really got into that. But how this started with me, and I haven't really told people this story before, but in 1998, I talk about in my visual memoir, Unstuck, I was in the seventh year of a not-so-great marriage. My mom was really pushing me to have a child, even though I've always known that that is not my life path. And I caved, and I got on fertility medicine and then ended up losing the baby. What I haven't told people is what happened during that process. And so when I went in for my 11-week checkup, I found out that the baby had expired at 8 weeks. And so I was on the verge of a miscarriage. They immediately put me into the hospital, and under anesthesia, my grandmother appeared to me. She had died 3 years before, and the sun was shining, it was warm, we were singing together, and I felt so peaceful and calm and happy. And so that's my first situation that I had felt anything of a spirit guide. But at that time, you know, I wasn't meditating, I didn't really know what spirit guides were. I just thought that that was a cool thing that she was there, you know, to make me feel comfortable. Well, fast forward to 2013. You know, I'm a professor in Connecticut. I had just started meditating. And through that, you know, several meditations in, I had one with Deepak Chopra, and he had the visualization that you're on a beach, you find a bottle, you find a blank piece of paper, and you write your top five things of what you want more in your life, put it in the bottle, and throw it out into the ocean. And so art was my first thing, because I hadn't painted probably since 2007. And I was really wanting more art in my life, whatever that meant. And after I wrote my five things, with art being first, put it in the bottle, you know, I'm visualizing this during meditation and throwing it into the ocean, my grandmother appeared on the beach. And so that was the first time that she had appeared since 1998. This was 2013. And I thought, oh, she's an artist, or, you know, she was. Maybe she's taking my art hope out there into the great unknown, you know, to make it possible. Wow. And so that's how it's kind of happened for me, is it's what shows up. Well, by 2014, getting into 2015, I knew that I needed to quit my professor position. And that was scary, because I had been there 12 years, you know, by the end of it, tenured. I was chair of my department for the last couple of years. And I was scared to death, but I just knew that I had to do it. Well, in January 2015, in Connecticut, my condo was infested with ladybugs. And for some reason, I just felt my grandmother's spirit in those ladybugs. You know, we had never talked about ladybugs while, you know, she was here on Earth. But something about those ladybugs, I just felt that's her. And so, you know, I would go into my laundry room and there would be five ladybugs in the window. Or I would be really worrying about something, you know, can I do this? Should I do this? And there would be one on my kitchen cabinet right when I'm having that thought. And so I knew that it was her pushing me, you know, to make this big decision. And I hired a life coach. I got through the process of turning in my resignation email. And when I had accomplished that, the ladybugs disappeared. And so I know that they were there as a guide to push me, to help me gently to take that huge leap of faith. And, you know, I had a friend in Connecticut. She's like, yeah, I have a lot of ladybugs in my house too, but it's not the same. But, you know, because it really meant something to me in that moment. And so it's a really cool thing.
Yeah. You know, one of the things that we're getting is, well, first of all, Terry Lynn wants to give a shout out to you, Vicki. They're watching on, they're watching on Facebook. They got a couple of questions for you. They want to know, what are you painting? Because we didn't tell folks what you were doing.
Well, I always do memoir portraits. And all so that's just kind of my thing, is to do female portraits. And we're going to see how this turns out. I'm feeling like she's kind of turning into that wild woman spirit in the desert with all of her little hippie flowers and everything. And so that's what it's going to be.
Yeah. You know, I spent time in the desert on several occasions doing vision questing, and actually I received my animal totem. My first animal totem was after going to the desert with my mentor, Sedona Cahill, who would take people out on 11-day vision quests in the desert.
Wow.
And I got lost. I wandered away.
Oh my goodness.
Of course I did. I wandered away from not just base camp, but I wandered away from my vision quest site. And I never looked back. I didn't pay attention to all the guidelines I was supposed to. And I found myself so far away. And I remember her saying to me, if you get lost, lay down with your heart in the sand and you will be guided.
Wow.
And I remember doing that, and that really leads to the conversation about intuition and gut feeling. And I lay down, and what happened was I wasn't looking up, but you know how you can feel a shadow of something over you, right?
Right.
You know how sometimes that thing blocks the sun? And
right.
Hovering over me, what I then later found out was a turkey vulture.
Oh,
and
my.
What happened was, it was so present for me that I looked up and it circled and then it started to fly and I followed it and it led me back to camp.
That is awesome.
When I told this story back at camp after being out in the desert with just water, having vision quest, some people call it a spiritual experience. I definitely do.
Right.
That's how it became my animal totem.
That's awesome.
Yeah. And so this is for folks that are tuning in. There is an intuition. There's an intuition in what you do. There's an intuition in what I do. How important is that for folks that are watching here? How will our intuition guide us, Vicki? And how do we trust it?
The intuition is everything, absolutely everything. And your guides will change. You know, they'll come and go. You may have a totem animal. I took a 2-day shaman retreat. It wasn't nearly as intense as being in the desert, but in this past August. And my totem animal that came is a deer. And I don't run into deer that often. And so the other animals that show up in my life, you know, are more the messengers, I think. And so after the ladybugs went away and it rolled around into 2016 and I had the chance to move to Washington State, I thought, oh my God, are you going to move cross country again? Because I'd already gone from Texas to Connecticut. Now I'm going to go all the way to Washington State. And you know, I'm doing this all by myself both times. And so hawks started showing up. And so I get with the big birds, right? And so my condo in Connecticut, I was on the end and it was right by the woods and my bedroom was on the third floor. And so usually with hawks, you know, you see them way up in the sky circling.
Yeah.
I was sitting there, you know, kind of thinking about stuff. You know, when you're going through all these life transitions, you find yourself just sitting and thinking a lot. And this hawk just, it was like slow motion, flew right by my eye line. I had a huge picture window in that bedroom. And I was like, oh my God, there he goes. And so outside my condo, I would see that hawk just sitting in trees, just kind of looking into my house. And I thought, this is the weirdest thing. So I looked up hawks, and, you know, it's to think higher, higher perspective, it's strength, it's, you know, fly high. And so after I decided to move to Washington State, the hawk became kind of my symbol. And it took me 6 days to drive cross country by myself. So I'm looking up in the sky as I'm driving and looking for my hawk, you know, signals. And they were always there. And so I have found that in times when you really need it,
yeah,
those spirit guides are there to kind of gently pull you. But I found since I've gotten here and kind of gotten settled, I still have the hawks. But one thing I didn't tell you, Pat, on the day of our first episode of Unstuck Joy in February, we're talking about feminine versus masculine traits. And before the show started, I'm up here in my office in this condo and looking out. There were three hawks circling high in the air, and they would go flap, 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 glide, flap, 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 glide. And I thought, that's hilarious. What does that mean? Well, after the show, I thought, that's the masculine and feminine traits, because we talked about how masculine is doing, doing, doing. Feminine is gliding and surrendering.
But there were three of them.
Yes. And for me, three is a big number.
But three is the Trinity. Three is the Holy Spirit. Three is body, mind, spirit. Three is a powerful number. What do you make of that?
Well, I looked, inevitably, if I look at the clock, there's going to be a three somewhere in there. It's just kind of become one of my things. I looked it up, and what I remembered most about the message in three is its manifestation. You know, there's some transformation in there, and that totally fits where I am right now. And so, you know, fours, I've heard that that's like an angel number, that the angels are with you. So there are anything that you can look up, plants, animals, numbers, they all have a message, and this is all considered spirit guides in some way.
All right. Listen, I got to give a shout out to a bunch of people, social media. Francis, is that you, Peanut? Oh my gosh. Hey, Dr. Pat, I associate butterflies with my late mother-in-law. It seems whenever I am joining the outdoors, here comes a beautiful butterfly and a feeling of joy comes over me. It's kind of like, oh, my goodness. It's kind of like a confirmation that life is good. Vicki,
oh,
isn't
beautiful.
That amazing? Now, you are going to do something with the picture. Tell folks what you're going to do. Hey, Francis.
That's beautiful, Francis. I would like to give this away. And so if people want to call in or, you know, Facebook in or whatever and let us know what your spirit animal is.
First, you're going to pick somebody.
Yes. And so I will
let's do it this
get
way.
Your email.
All right. So for those of you that want to, Vicki's going to do this totally intuitively. On Facebook, Jessica has all the people that are talking to us on Facebook. So Jessica's going to make sure she gets your names down. And so for those of you that are not able to do social media, just call into the show. Benny will get your name. Tell Benny. What animal speaks to you? 1-800-930-2819. So we're going to do this in a couple of ways. Benny can take your information. What's the animal speaking to you? And we're going to need your phone number. If you're on social media, yeah. Oh, Francis. Yes. Aunt Patty. I think I'm going to cry.
Oh.
I think I'm going to cry. 1-800-930-2819. Vicki?
Yes?
Nobody knows exactly what that's turning out to be, because you don't even know.
I don't know. That makes it good, though. Yeah, I'm feeling she's going to be a little hippie chick.
She's going to be a little... I was a hippie chick.
Yeah.
I was a big hippie chick. I was so seriously... I used to have the leather headband and everything on there.
Oh, cool.
And you, actually, I had long hair.
Wow.
I had really long hair.
I used to, too. Here we both are with short hair and blonde.
You know what my friends say to me? They look at me now and they say, okay, like, when did your hair get white? I said, I pay good money to get this to look like this. I actually am a brunette. Let's take a short break, everybody. We'll be right back.
So funny.
Some talk radio networks broadcast whatever they want to, whether the vibration is high or low, without regard for another's journey. They focus on the problem and not the solution. Other networks tune in to the highest vibration possible to help us live life full out, to help us stand in our yes, and cultivate a platform for positive change.
Hey, everybody, how's it going? You're with Artie and Sky, the dynamic duo.
Hello, this is Colette Marie Steffen. Welcome to The Truth is Funny on Transformation Talk Radio.
You're listening to The Human Experience. I'm Dr. Steve Maraboli.
Hello, this is Dr. Nusheen Darvish.
And hi, I'm Dr. Pat Basile, and you are listening to Lime Talk Radio.
These networks don't come often, but when they do, they remind us that we can achieve anything that is possible to help ourselves, to help others, and to help the planet.
Hello, everyone. I'm Dr. Jeff Lineweaver, and you're listening to Dialogue Radio.
Hello, and welcome to the Psychic Love Doctor Show.
Hey, everybody. It is so great. I'm Dr. Pat. Thank you so much for joining us.
This is Dr. Ronnie, your host.
Hi, everyone, and welcome, welcome to We Carry the Light. I'm Dr. Susan.
Hi, this is Chuck Gallagher with Straight Talk Radio.
These networks aren't concerned with bombarding us with bad news. They aren't concerned with sensationalizing an individual's setbacks or challenges. These networks focus on amazing, innovative broadcasting.
Hello, everyone. It's great to be back here with you today. I'm Dr. Jen.
Oh, welcome to Voices of Women.
Hello, everyone. I'm Kelly Ballard.
They provide a distinct blend of live talk radio interviews with a mix of uplifting and intelligent educational information.
Hello, good evening, and welcome to Psychic World. I am indeed John G. Sutton.
Hello, everyone. I am Dr. Kelly, and you are listening to Lucid Planet Radio.
Hello there. This is Leslie Fontaine. This is Sheer Alchemy.
These innovative networks remind us that everything is possible, that nothing is limited.
Habits of Health Talk with Russ McCann.
Welcome to Spirit Fire Radio. I'm Tim Darter.
And I'm Steve Kramer.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to the Christine Upchurch Show.
Transformation Radio is one of these networks. Some talk radio networks broadcast whatever they want to, whether the vibration is high or low, without regard for another's journey. They focus on the problem and not the solution. Other networks tune in to the highest vibration possible to help us live life full out, to help us stand in our yes, and cultivate a platform for positive.
Hey, everybody, welcome back. It's so great to have all of you tune us in and turn us on. For more information about me, go to thedrpatshow.com, or you can just Google Dr. Pat. I can't believe Peanut called me Dr. Pat, but then she came back and called me Aunt Patty. I feel better.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, it's kind of cool. And for you, Vicki, can you tell folks, first of all, how they can find out more about you, but also you're setting up workshops. You're doing a whole lot of things.
Yes. My website is the best way to reach me. So it's Vicki World Art, V-I-C-K-I, worldart.com. And so I have an art workshops link. I have a contact me link with my email. We have an art visioning link, and we're going to start talking about the art visioning prompt here in a minute. And a radio link, a books link. And so there's all kinds of stuff on the website. So that's the easiest way to contact me.
So let me give you a little feedback here from folks. You know, Natalia, thank you for your comment as well. Don't know how you are able to paint, have a conversation while being live on Facebook. Very impressive, lovely paintings. I love the colors. She also said, such a great show. I've seen an owl on my daily walk and it really stuck with me. I see it as a symbol of wisdom. So I love her question. Let's talk about how you're able to do this, because that leads to intuition, doesn't it?
Yes.
And you're going to tell folks, you're actually going to reveal this art piece today. So they're not going to have to wait.
No, they are not. And Natalia, I was wondering how I was going to do this too, but somehow it's all worked out. but before we started, I called in my grandmother who, you know, has passed, and she was an artist. And I said, please take care of the art part of this, because it is like walking and chewing gum, and I've never done this before. And so, you know, here we are. So spirits are there to guide you through stuff, which is really nice.
Yeah. And, you know, all of this is, I asked you during the break, I don't know, folks are seeing something, I think they're seeing videos. And I said to you, what's happening here is a demonstration of spirit coming to life through intuition. And this is how we can really live our lives. I got to tell you that that's how I live my life. You know, when I look at this, Vicki, and people say to me, you got to be out of your mind. What are you launching? Transformation Radio, 10 right. channels. And then when I talk about it, folks say to me, how are you doing it? I'm not doing it. The people that are doing it are the people that are running this video on Facebook. They're the team of people that brought this to be. There's Alex, there's Jessica, there's Linda, there's Christina, there's Kim, there's Michael, there's Megan. These are the people. There's Benny pushing the right buttons today. There's Alex running the video. There's Jessica that did all the prep work. That's why you and I get to show up and simply have fun. And then, yes. by the way, most importantly, there's all of you.
Yes.
You are the reason that I get up every day and I think about how many other networks can we expand to? How can we reach people in India? How can we reach people in China? How can we reach people in Chicago? That's what gets me started every day. And then this amazing team of people, they perform magic.
Yes, but without thank you, guys.
Without intuition, none of this is happening, is it?
No, it's not. It's absolutely not. And so I'm going to let this sit for a while and see where she is.
All right. Tell us about the process. Tell us about what's happening. Some people may just be tuning in.
Okay. Well, I'm doing a somewhat intuitive energy painting. And so my hope is that from me, you know, really stepping into doing my life purpose of being an artist who inspires others. Hopefully the energy will come through that and it will inspire you guys out there to really step into your own calling, whatever that may be. And so that is my hope. I'm going to have to sit with this and see where we go. But in addition to this painting, we have a way for viewers to play along on their own with an art visioning prompt. And so all of the instructions are on my website, VickiWorldArt.com, under the art visioning link. And right underneath that is art vision prompts. And so this particular prompt is discover your spirit animals. And so, you know, we've had everything today from a ladybug to a vulture, hawk, or whatever your desert animal was. And so, you know, that's pretty cool. So what you'll do, and I have my examples here, is it's kind of a two-part thing. Go find an element of nature. You know, I got flowers out of the garden around my condo. I clipped off some of the newly budding tree branches, you know, just a little bit. In the workshop I had on Saturday with this, I went and got tulips from the grocery store. So just what a seashell, you know, whatever you can find. And pick out something that resonates with you and look at it. You know, look at the structure, feel it, but then close your eyes and sense it through smell, through touch. Imagine that there's a connection between you and that flower or seashell, whatever it is. Imagine that it's sensing you back. You know, what would that connection look like? And then open your eyes and intuitively draw on your art journal page what that looks like. And it doesn't have to be a realistic representation. It could just capture the emotion and the feeling. And so I don't know if you guys can see it, but like on this one, this was a green leaf, but I did it, you know, with all of these layers of color, because I thought if I were a leaf, I'd want to have all these layers, you know, of this wonderful color and these things, you know, kind of coming off of it. Because when I look at stuff in nature, a lot of times it has little, you know, little feelers coming off of it.
Yeah.
And just, you know, kind of the curve. And I got this thing that had little moss balls all over it. And so, you know, it turned into dots. And so just create a nature page. And then, and all the instructions are on that art visioning page of Discover Your Spirit Animal. There's a guided meditation for you to close your eyes. Think of your perfect sanctuary in nature. Maybe it's on the beach, under the ocean, on a mountaintop, in the forest, in a field with flowers, and envision yourself there. And in that space, you're going to imagine that a door appears. What does it look like? How do you open it? And all of that. Once you go through that door, that's when you invite your spirit animals to come forward and say, "Are you my spirit animal?" And they may say no. I remember during the shaman retreat, I really wanted for an elephant to come forward because we did the same meditation. Yeah. Elephant came forward and he said, "Nope, I'm not your animal." And so I'm like, okay. So, you know, then the deer came forward. Okay, that's fine. So accept whatever comes and ask your animal or animals, what is the message that you have for me? What do you want to teach me? And as you've gone through that process, then open your eyes and do the same thing on your nature page. Intuitively collage or draw what your animals are and the messages that popped up for you. It's like here I have the ladybug, which is my grandmother. It's encouragement, direction, guidance, protection. A hummingbird, which I haven't mentioned. I have a lot around my office here. But be light, playful, joy, adapt. Because, you know, sometimes I get really type A in my masculine doing. And the hummingbird reminds me to lighten up, right? I did a crow. And this one, I created my own collage paper by just using acrylic paints and inks and then tore.
Oh, that's beautiful.
Yeah. And yeah. So I didn't really, because, you know, to me, crow is kind of scary. I always think of Edgar Allan Poe. But when I looked it up on Google, it says higher perspective, speak your truth, see your future self and shift into that reality, because they look with both eyes. So they're kind of in both worlds.
Yeah.
So see your true self and then shift into that.
Okay. And are you going to reveal what you painted today?
Yes.
Let's show everyone.
Just about there.
Yeah, that's good because we got about 5 minutes.
Oh, good.
But, you know, you'll finish her up. I mean, you know, even if we go off air here, that doesn't mean you're not
Can you see all of that?
Yeah, let's just hold it up there. Keep holding it up for everyone.
Okay, so sometimes when I paint, and it's the same way when you do your own art visioning pages, the universe kind of tells you what it is. And yes, I had a plan. I knew I was doing a woman with flowers, but it turned out a little bit different than what I had seen in my mind. But I'm seeing her as gathering all these little messages from her spirit guides, and that's each little flower, and it's integrating into her. You know, instead of blush on her cheek, she's got flowers and the flowers in her hair. And so it's almost like she's blending into these messages. And so that's what I'm seeing, is that she's using her intuition. She's accepting the messages and she's allowing that to become her and then go forward into her wild woman spirit, evolving closer into her true self.
Wow. Hold it up there a little bit longer.
Okay.
Wow. Folks are saying that they are so touched by this, Vicki, that they are wanting to try the process that you just described.
Yes. Do I have time to say one more thing?
Please do.
Okay, with the art visioning process, it's a little bit beyond just art journaling. So I have a list of questions that you ask the universe. Like, what do I need to discover about this? Who do I need to be? What do I need to shed? What do I need to allow? So I think after you create your nature page, invite your spirit animals to come in, get them on the page with their messages that you perceived, then at that point, go to the art visioning questions and say, hey, universe, what do I need to know about this to really incorporate and use those messages in my life? And it will go a little bit deeper than just Googling the message.
All right, hold her up again. Now, one of the things I want to ask you about her is each of the components, I believe, have some symbolic meaning to you and the person perhaps that's going to get this, right?
Okay. I don't know about them, but I can tell you what I'm getting out of this. I always gravitate toward pink and purples because those are my favorite colors. One reason I really like pink, and you know, asking my grandmother to help me in this process today, she had literally a pink brick house. I mean, her house was pink carnation colored brick. And she had an art studio, a china shop. She sold china and she taught oil painting classes on china and canvas. And so she gave me all of her china that had pink flowers because that was both of our favorite colors. And so there's a lot of femininity and a lot of pink, a little bit of orange. But when I see pink flowers, I'm reminded of her spirit. So that's what this means to me.
Mm. And would you, I mean, the thing that I'm really struck by is it's really clear to me, and I'm sure of the folks watching, that you were intuitively called to paint that in the way that you did. You were obviously getting some information that guided your hand along the way. And, you know, we have a few minutes. I'd love for you to just touch upon that if you could.
Okay. That's hard to explain. I don't consider myself an intuitive artist that you have no plan at all. Because usually I do have a plan that, you know, I'll use a face. Let me show you. I have a reference photo here from the magazine. And so it's not exact, but it's something, you know, that I can kind of focus on to bring that feeling into it. Mm-hmm. But other than that, I cannot tell you how many times, whether it's in my art visioning journal or on the canvas or something like this, it informs me. And so there's some of that magical, you know, universal power that says, oh, you thought you knew what you were painting, but this is really what it's going to be. Right. And so when I got up into this area, I wasn't sure what that would be, but this is what happened.
So,
we're just going to go with it.
Well, the next time you're on, I'm going to bring some beautiful goddess heads that I created.
Yes.
And I went through a phase, and all of a sudden they called to be created, and I haven't done any in years. So there was a series of them that wanted to be created, and they literally told me everything about color. And believe me, I don't know about color. I haven't studied. I'm not an artist in that way. But for somehow during this one period of my life, six of these came forward.
Wow.
Six of them. And it'll be interesting to talk about that next time, because there will be a next time. Yes. Thank you for today. I want to ask you this final thing to share. Please share the website. Also tell folks that are wanting to know, how do I get the art prompt? And then what's your personal message for today?
Okay. The website is Vicki World Art, V-I-C-K-I worldart.com. On the menu, there's an art visioning link. And so that will give you all the information about what art visioning is, the benefits. There's an art supply list, the questions to the universe and all that. Underneath that, it says art vision prompts. And so there's a prompt for each of the episodes of Unstuck Joy. This one is called Discover Your Spirit Animals. And so there's a ton of information on that page of how to do your own in your art vision journal. The message for today, be curious. And when you see that feather on your kitchen floor, like I did last night, you know, that was such a big thing for me right before doing this thing that I've never done before. Or when you see that cat that keeps showing up, like you said, outside your window, maybe they're there to tell you something. Or, you know, you have a dream and somebody shows up in your dream. Try to remember it and jot it down. And so be curious, follow the clues, sing over it, like we talked about with La Loba, you know, to bring all those clues together. Bring in your intuition. Be curious enough to Google it. Find a book. See what the message is. And whatever resonates with you is the truth. Because go with your intuition at the moment. Don't over-rationalize.
And here's what folks are saying about what you've created. Natalia says, beautiful. So does Francis. Bree says, a goddess. A beautiful painting. A beautiful, intuitive, feminine goddess. Thank you for making a difference, Vicki.
Oh, thanks to everybody out there. And thank you, Dr. Pat, and everybody on the team.
I want to thank you all for tuning us in, turning us on. And it sounds like this is something you all would like to see more of. I'm in. Thank you all. We'll see you next time.
Bye.
You've been listening to Unstuck Joy, the art of living on purpose with Vicki Todd. This hit show is where your higher purpose is revealed and cultivated. Now you too can share your unique light and special gifts with the world. Vicki's dedication to raising your life's purpose to something extraordinary is unending. So don't miss out on your opportunity. Catch Unstuck Joy monthly with Vicki Todd and Dr. Pat Basile. For more information about Vicki and her work, go to VickiWorldArt.com. That's VickiWorldArt.com.